Previously.
DMZ tour. That might be interesting.
When I found out I was going to be traveling to South Korea, one of the things on the top of my list was the DMZ. I know you're thinking, that rapper in the 2000s who would bark all the time? No, that was DMX. Or you're thinking, the place I go to get my driver's license? Close, but that's the DMV.
Wait, they're all slots?
The DMZ, or the Demilitarization Zone, is a strip of land running across the Korean Peninsula that separates North Korea from South Korea, and it has been a designated buffer zone since the Korean Armistice Agreement in 1953. However, as of January 2011, North Korea has violated this armistice 221 times, including 26 military attacks. After hearing that, I'm sure we're all in agreement that that sounds like a smart place to visit. Originally, I was not sure how to make my way up to the DMZ, so I contacted the hotel I was staying at. They informed me that the only way to see the DMZ was through one of the local tours. Luckily for me, they had a brochure of the tour, and I set something up. The tour informed me I needed to bring my passport with me, and the bus would pick me up at 7 a.m., and it was packed. One thing that I found out was that some of the locations were no longer accessible to the general public as of 2020. Unfortunately, one of these areas was the JSA, or the Joint Security Area. The other one was the Dorasan train station. The JSA is the area that straddles the open border of North Korea and South Korea. You used to be allowed to briefly enter one of the rooms where you would see a North Korean soldier that would be constantly posted at the door, which I thought was pretty cool. Hopefully it opens up again so I can possibly do another trip. The train station was built as a symbol of hope that one day both nations would reunify and this station would stand as a gateway to North Korea. You're probably thinking, man, John, those sound really cool. If you can't do that, then what are you allowed to do? Well, we're allowed to go to Imjanggak Park, the Dora Observatory, and the Third Tunnel. On our first stop on the tour was the park. It was located outside of the DMZ and was originally built as a safe place for those who fled North Korea. This is a popular spot to visit because you do not need to go through any military checkpoints to get to it. The one main attraction of the site is the old train that's filled with bullet holes because it was caught in the crossfire of the Korean War. Thank you. After leaving the park, we headed to the DMZ. We had to go through a military checkpoint where our tour guide verified our names with the soldiers and they checked our passports. This would be one of the many times we were told we weren't allowed to take any photos and had to put our cell phones away. After the checkpoint, we were able to head to our first site in the DMZ, the Dora Observatory. The observatory is one of the few places where you can look into North Korea. Going to the observation deck, you are able to look through the binoculars into North Korea. We were informed that the North Korean military were also viewing us, which is understandable. From the observatory, we were able to see the North Korean town of Kijongdong. This town features several brightly painted concrete multi-story buildings and apartments. An interesting fact is that based on modern telescope lenses, it was discovered that these buildings are nothing but concrete shells without glass windows or interior rooms. The entire town is mostly empty, besides a crew of people that come out to do the caretaking. After getting pictures and looking into North Korea, we headed to our next stop on the tour, the third tunnel. There were currently four tunnels discovered crossing the DMZ that were dug by North Korea. The third tunnel, the one we'd be going in, was discovered in 1978 by a North Korean defector and took 4 months to locate. The tunnel is approximately 1 mile long and runs 240 feet below ground and has a maximum height around 7 feet. The North Koreans, however, denied that they built the tunnel and insisted that it belonged to South Korea, but eventually changed their story and said it was built for a coal mine. They believed it was designed for a surprise attack on Seoul since it was only 27 miles away from the city. When getting to the site of the third tunnel, we were taken into a room. We were given hard hats and told we would need to put our phones and cameras into a locker. Since I was unable to take any video, I'm respecting their wishes and not posting a video from another area of YouTube. You can look up the third tunnel video if you'd like. Going down into the tunnel would be the closest we would get to North Korea. If you followed the path all the way to the last allowable point, you would be 170 meters from the North Korean border. The height of the tunnel would get lower and lower the further you went in. We walked in no problem, but when we got about halfway, we had to crouch to continue. As I walked, I would hear a slam every 10 to 20 seconds of a tourist hitting their head on top of the tunnel. After walking out of the tunnel, we wandered around the site, taking pictures of the giant DMZ sign and the old tank. I picked up a souvenir barbed wire that was used in the fencing on the DMZ, which I thought was pretty cool. We then all got on the bus and headed back through the military checkpoints where we were dropped off at the hotel. Overall, I wish I got to go see the JSA, but I would still recommend going to see the DMZ if you find yourself in South Korea for some reason. Maybe I'll make it back to see the JSA at some point in the future. Well, that's it for me on this trip. See you guys next time.
Like and subscribe!